I'm going to start off today's show by saying you're welcome. Why, you ask? Well, because we're taking the guesswork out of the best cars to buy in whatever segment you're looking for this President's Day. That is right. What's up, everybody? I'm Derek D, and this is Fastlane Daily's 2013 President's Day Especial. So let's get right to it. Here are what we think are the best cars in each segment up to about $25,000 before options, all right? They're in no particular order. And here we go. We're gonna start off with sports cars. It was easily one of the best cars introduced this past year, the Scion FRS. It has style, it's a classic front engine, rear-wheel drive setup, handles like a champion, or well, I'd maybe take those stock tires off if I were you. And of course, you will always have the 6-speed manual option. It can also be easily modified. It's super lightweight and comes with the reliability of a Toyota-sourced engine. Score! Also, apply pretty much everything I just said to the Subaru BRZ. All right? Now to compacts. The Dodge Dart. Yeah, it's gotten mixed reviews to the max. And I don't mean mixed reviews by Max, who's standing right here. No, not him. But in plain facts, it's a great-looking car. Yeah, I said it, Tom. It is. It has plenty of cabin space, nice features, big screen, a solid engine if you opt for that 2.4-liter Tiger Shark 4-bomber. And you can score one for under 20 Gs, and I stay G'd up. So I'm saying, get yourself a Dodge Dart if you don't want to go that expensive. Okay, how about a 4x4? What do you guys think?
G-Class wagon.
Ah, Jeep Wrangler. That's way more than our price range. Come on, a Jeep Wrangler, obviously. And it has been one of the best off-road values on the market for decades. And new or old, the out-of-the-box capabilities are friggin' amazing. There is a reason the Jeep Wrangler has been around for so long, people, okay? There's torque for days, ground clearance for many obstacles, limitless modification potential. The shape is as timeless as the 911, and it all starts at $22,000. Boom, Max. What do you think?
Okay.
Yeah. Let's go to luxury. And I say that in quotes because there really isn't much luxury you can get for 25 grand. But with a bit of haggling, you can get yourself a base model Audi A3 hatch. What's so good about it, you ask? Well, surprisingly great performance, German engineering, lovely interior, and duh, it's an Audi. But all that being said, it's 2013, people, okay? Luxury is your own interpretation. What was luxurious and really expensive years ago, you can now find in a Kia Soul, or a Hyundai Elantra, or a Chevy Cruze, a Honda Civic. The list goes on. Okay? So you get my point. Sedans. I'm just going to say it. Ford Fusion. Go for it. Looks like an Aston Martin a little bit. Has solid fuel economy, a totally overhauled interior design, great technology, and a punchy little engine on tap. But it can't fly like it does in this commercial. So don't try to do that. But it is a nice car. All right, how about a hybrid? Here we go. Now, I'm going to probably get a lot of shit for this, but we got to call a spade here. One of the originals and still a solid buy, whether you like the way it looks or not, the Toyota Prius. Yeah, you can mock it all you want, but the endearing wedge-shaped design offers amazing utility, 51 combined MPGs, a comfortable cabin, and that awesome hipster appeal, you know, if you're into that. And there are like four different Prius versions, three of which are in the $25,000 price range that we're talking about.
There's right? Also that champagne compartment.
And right, in the glove compartment, you can put a champagne bottle in there. It's made for it. Now to trucks. Go out and get yourself a GMC Sierra 1500 with free maintenance for 2 years. The boxy design is good to look at. It's obviously a capable ride, and even though they just redesigned the model, a 2013 looks very similar and will be a reliable hunk of metal for years. And don't you worry, Ford folks, we fully endorse the F-150 as well. Yeah, go America! Right, Max?
Yeah, throw some hammers in there.
Throw some hammers in there in the truck and boom, built Ford tough. All right, now to the hot hatch we go. Our first instinct was to opt for the original, the Golf GTI, right? And for good reason. German engineering, clean look, affordable. But we think that was slightly overruled by the sheer performance opportunity in the Focus ST. For 23 grand, you can apply 250 ponies to the front wheels and take corners faster than this car probably should. FLD approved, my friends. That's the Ford Focus ST. I'm not hating on the GTI We're just saying. Lastly, let's head to crossover land, where we think the Mazda CX-5 is the way to go. I test drove this little crossover and was overwhelmingly impressed. For $22,000, you can have a light, all-wheel drive CX-5 that definitely has that zoom, 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 where zoom, 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 ready to handle the kids, groceries, its fair share of twisties, and it's sharp looking. A little small, good-looking SUV there. Crossover, okay? So, there you go. You're all informed, prepared, and hungry for a value. Take the FLD knowledge and apply it to some great cars. Oh, and don't forget to comment if you took our advice or if you disagree with any of our segment winners. I'm sure there'll be no shortage of you telling us that as well. And we welcome it. All right? We aren't the be-all and end-all here. We just give you info like a boss.
Boss.
Thank you, Rick. What was that, Tom? Oh, okay. Listen, enjoy your day off, America. I'm Derek D. This was the 2013 Fastlane Daily President's Day Special. Thanks for watching, and I will talk to all of you tomorrow. Oh, yeah. Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, iTunes, Instagram, T-shirts, FLD.
Twitter? Facebook?
Is Max not in today?
We'll start off with sports cars. It was easily one of the best cars introduced.
Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding me? Shut up! Oh, it's f- and comes with the reliability of a Toyota